This is Neo with a replay cast. Unfortunately, due to work, I have no time to cast live in the evening hours, but I still wanted to provide you with some Warcraft content here on our YouTube channel, so I had to pre-tape this one. This is the W3Arena.net replay of the week. It is a 2-on-2 between Dirk and Ono versus Select and Ton. Or Ton UD, I will call him Ton, because it fits better in the scoreboard. And yeah, before we start the game, some stuff we have to mention. This Friday, October 23rd, it's in 3 days, we have the WCA Open Qualifier for Europe. You're all invited to participate. $5,800 prize money, 2 slots to China, and yeah, even if you're a noob, please sign up, play the tournament, so let's make a statement that Warcraft 3 is still alive, that the scene is more active than it has been throughout the last 4 years or something. And let's just enjoy this. We will cast this thing, Remo, me and yours, at twitch.tv/backtowarcraft. So this, hopefully, is going to be the biggest cup we've seen since 2004, maybe. I really beg you to support us on this mission. So let's dive into the game. 1:30, and here in the bottom right corner you can see something new. We advertise our new shops, so you can buy our merchandise to support us. Shirts, mugs, pillows, hoodies, whatever you can imagine we have there. Alrighty, let's start this. In the upper part of Turtle Rock, we see Dirk with an Archmage first with his ally Ono. Both players playing human here. Both players going for the Archmage. So I'm wondering if we will see a Water Elemental Blizzard combination. And as you can see here, in the upper part, in the lower part of our Observer tool, we have a Dreadlord, everybody. Double Undead for Select and Ton. Ton UD. So we have Ghouls and Fiends first, both, and here we see a Lich. So no DK, no healing, no nothing. This is a super unusual matchup. We haven't seen it in like WC3L back then. Well, Undead was kind of cool on ladder. I played it a lot myself. It's a lot of fun, but usually you play double DK to be able to heal your allies DK. So that makes it more interesting. This time we have Dreadlord and Lich. So let's see what we will get here, how this pans out. On the side of Dirk and Ono, Archmage of course crept the green spots, crept this one here, so the first items, Ring of Protection and something. But this is 2-on-2 obviously, so it's a lot different from the 1-on-1 type we see here. Dreadlord skilled the Sleep first, and I think the Lich will go for... yeah, most likely Frost Armor, I guess. Or maybe Nova would be awesome as well. So, most likely Nova. Yeah, we see it here because there will be tons and tons of footmen. So he can Nova slow them all, whatever. No expansion yet, no tech yet. But we see a Lumber Mill from Select, so this will most likely result in... in an expansion. I don't think they tower rush an undead. We have double Water Elemental skill build, but only one Brilliance Aura. Both going for Brilliance Aura. I think this is a waste, because you only need it once. Here's the first Sleep on the Archmage, trying to surround. There's no unit nearby to hit him, and no, the surround is not closed. Maybe another Sleep. Nova comes first. Here comes the Sleep. Second surround attempt, and close it is. Archmage has to town portal out, so Ono with the first problem here, but maybe his ally can do something good. Maybe Dirk can make up for it. Maybe creeping the way to level 3. Yeah, stealing the turtles in front of Select's base. So tier 2 techs by both undead. As I mentioned before, we have ghouls and fiends. So far I can see only ghouls. Let's see. Yeah, both players going for ghouls now. But the fiend switch will come sooner than later. With sleep, of course, it's super easy to creep the spots. I don't think he has mana left, though. But you see it here. Rune of the Watcher in 2-on-2. Even more important than it is as in 1-on-1. Oh, Tomb of Experience. Nice. A high-level Dreadlord always supports you. The sleep gets cheaper in mana, and of course the aura is great for the ghouls, and later for the A-bombs. But here we see the Magi creep from the human team as well. Rune of the Watcher and Claws +9. What did we see here? probably, no, the parry up. So both items decent, I'd say, medium at best. So, okay, creeping from the human team. Archmage catches the Nova, catches the sleep. Is he able to connect? No attack to the Archmage. He's still asleep, but no mana anymore. What? He attacks his own Archmage. Archmage, what's he doing? And here comes Nova. Kills him. Did he try to deny him? I don't think so. Oh, surround on the Dreadlord. This game is already fun, as far as I can tell. Here comes malicious support. Maybe another surround. No! Just a little too late. So the undead heroes survive. And the human, one human hero is dead at the moment. But both players going for attack. No expansion. Archmage revive. We have the lumber mill here. We have the lumber mill here. So they are ready for towers or an expansion. Sorry. Double panda and brewmaster. Alright. I'd say go mass destroyers. Both. And then the panda is completely useless. Graveyard just in time here. Ooh! Double Temple of the Damned. That is interesting. And a slaughterhouse. Is this Necro Wagons? It's gotta be, right? Gotta be Necro Wagons. We see Cannibalism, an upgrade we see very rarely. So he might want to play with a lot of corpses. Ooh boy, I'm looking forward to this one. No second heroes for the undead. And here's more creeping, of course. Pan and Brewmaster gets really strong at level 3. Castle tech right away from Dirk. And here we see double Arcane Sanctum. So, Breakers, Griffins or something? Could imagine that. Skeleton's still trying to get rid of the Archmage, but he is level 3 now. He should be able to escape, but there is more Nova where that one came from. Just needs to wait for the cooldown. 40 HP. Oh, Shadow Meld saves him. Is there dust? No, there's not. Okay, there is a town portal. So he can escape if there's a shade or dust or whatever. But now he needs to get rid of the human army that's on the Lich's ass. In the meantime, the Dreadlord is back here very, very close to level 3. Nighttime is almost over. Here he comes. Nova! And the Archmage goes down for the second time. Sleep. Will he get the surround? Ooh, counter surround. Very well done by Dirk. Saving this Panda and Brewmaster here. No more Nova. But there is one more sleep, everybody. Counter surround again. So he will be able to escape. And I think he closed it again with the skeletons now. Nah, just barely escapes. Just barely escapes. But he took so many hits in that surround. Lich has to be careful. There is no coil yet. Ooh, Breath of Fire hit a lot with Drunken Haste. He takes damage over time, but here comes the saving coil. Death Knight, help is on the way as Rise Against Song would play now. That would be awesome. So lots of towers for the undead. He needs to buy time, as it seems. We see the meat wagons. We see meat wagons from Tanyudi as well. Double slaughterhouse meat wagons. Wow, he will play. He'll have a lot of corpses. We see it for the necros. Immediately scouting master training and skeletal mastery. Now he's on tier 3. So the human needs to scout that, and he needs dispel like now. He has priests, but no adept. A lot of upgrades already. 0-1, 1-1 is coming. Breakers here. But he can take over the summons. That would be horrible, man. Imagine all the skeletons being turned. So, one human is going for breakers, the other one? I don't know. Nothing yet. Paladin, second hero. He's going for Arcane Sanctum as well, but also... Okay, that's just for upgrades, as it seems. Or is he... No, knights. Knights and breakers? That's weird. No aviary yet, so... I don't know what he's doing, but we'll find out. So I think the human is better in the late game. So he needs to do... The undead push needs to hit really, really hard. There's no level 3 Lich. Tanyudi morphing into destroyers here. He got a decent amount of meat wagons. Level 3 on the Dreadlord, level 1 on the DK, almost level 2, so the aura is really, really important. But now we go to the big spots. Red spot coming for the humans, and the orange turtles on the back of the turtle here for the undead. Lich will definitely get level 3 here. No Orb of Corruption yet. Just the staff, boots, and the periapt. See the necromancers. Of course, they can summon skeletons, unholy frenzy, and cripple. Unholy frenzy gives a huge amount of attack speed, but costs hit points. And cripple is a super slow. And less damage, I guess. Potion of greater healing. Potion of greater mana. Very, very nice for all undead. Aura level 2 on level 3. So no sleep level 1, level 2. But more HP for the ghouls. We have, of course, Frenzy. And we see Crystal Ball here. Worst item he can get. But the expansion for Ono is almost up. And the human player got both red spots. We see here the Hood of Cunning is okay for the Pan and Brewmaster, but not the best one he can get. Gyrocop the Flag Cannon upgrade against Destroyers. Nice transition from the human team. And yeah, we're waiting for the first big clash. Oh, wow. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 7 Necros, 3 Meat Wagons. Holy moly, that's gonna hit him hard. I don't know if there's Dispel. There's no Dispel. There is no Dispel, everybody. And this, it's not been scouted. It still has not been scouted that there's Necro Wagons coming. Oh, that Breath of Fire hit hard. Ooh, that Breath of Fire was horrible. Double Breath of Fire, of course, against this army. Absolutely perfect. Since there's no Dispel, he needs to do the damage against it. But a huge blocker line now. Next Breath of Fire killing a lot. Oh my god, they are leveling so fast. But look at the summons, man! There's so many of them. 11 and 12 skeletons, like 23 combined mages and blocker skeletons, warriors. What shall he do? What can he do against this? Okay, the towers have to fight now, but there are 3 destroyers, but they have no mana, so the towers can really do good here. Here the skeletons have to tank. Ooh, that destroyer has been coiled once. It's be micro away. Yeah, now all the skeleton mages are in. But mass repair as well. The paladin is in problems, and he will go down. There's nothing that can save him. Boom, hero is dead. And, yeah, looks kind of cool. Looks kind of cool. Still a lot of damage. Oh, nice sleep here on the Panda. And Brewmaster was just about to hit the Breath of Fire again, but does it nevertheless. Sleep is not for eternity. Here comes Coil Nova. No, just Nova and the follow-up. Can still sleep. He has level 2 sleep here. Tons of damage, but no. Oh. DK died thanks to the Archmage. But here comes sleep, but no follow-up. But all the summons were used to kill the expansion, or almost killing the expansion. HP from the skeleton mages cut in half once again. And every unit that the humans lose will result in 2 new skeletons. Potion of healing being used. And the Dreadlord still trying to get some hits here. Panda just barely... Oh, nice! Tomb of Retraining being used. We see Blizzard now. And that's, of course, awesome against all these little summons, but yeah, the expansion is gone, and so the humans lost a lot of time. But it is hard now for the undead to get the skeletons back in on mana. I think they used all of it. See, the first gyros could take on with the destroyers. Yeah, here they come. Area of effect, piercing damage, super effective. 1 destroyer down. No, barely saved. No, he gets killed. And yeah, we have a level 4.5 Pendant Brewmaster. Level 4 Archmage. Level 4 Archmage. They killed a lot of skeletons. A lot of skeletons. Okay, we still have 4 meat wagons. Lots of corpses again. He's trying to go for the expo. Destroyer has been saved. Nice. Almost level 5 Dreadlord. 4-3 here. Single Dreadlord. Alright. 4-4, 4-3-1. That's kind of normal. The Sanctuary. And supply-wise, they look pretty equal. A good amount of mana has been regenerated. So he can try... Oh, yeah, Scroll of Healing and a Scroll of Protection. Ay-ay-ay-ay-ay. Did he go for Adept? Yes, he has Dispel now. Onu has Dispel now. Oh, no, I mean... And he's going for the base, but the human is well aware, sniping that meat wagons. They are so important, they provide the casters with all the corpses. He needs to pull through, he cannot micro them away. Yeah, here we see a lot of corpses once again, a lot of skeletal mages once again. Can they take on with the army, with the dispel, with everything? Two meat wagons. Oh my god, this Breath of Fire! it's hard to miss something here with all the mass summons. But still, woohoo! Dispel and Breath of Fire. It's just beautiful to watch. All the summons dying. And yeah, this is a level 5. No, level 3 still. Where's the other panda? Ah, I thought he would be level 3. A level 5. What's wrong in my head? So, 16 minutes have been played. We have seen a beautiful skeleton push. But now it is time for the humans to shine. They have knights, they have a lot of casters, but there's no heavy air yet, because there's no expansion. Oh, only now. Oh, did he drop here? Oh, there it is, the meat wagon. He could have killed the trees, then walk over here and get vision somehow and attack the town hall from there. Would have been a nice little move. Okay, and here we go. This time fighting in an undead base, and you know what they say. This is never a good thing. Scroll of Protection being used already. Nova to fight the panda once, but I think it's not enough. Good that he has four towers in his base. The only summons now come from the graveyard. There's only one meat wagon, but without corpses. Here comes his ally defending this. Of course, they are destroyers, so they can dispel a lot. Yeah, he should dispel the Scroll of Protection. I feel the panda has some problems, but Invul Potion and Holy Light saves him for now. Everything gets healed back up from the priests, but the destroyers focus them well, and there's still a good amount of meat wagons dealing with them here. Oh, Paladin once again in trouble, as is the panda. Paladin goes down for the second time. Level 5 on the Dreadlord, and I'd love to see him transition into Carrion Swarm. Oh, surround. Yeah, this panda is dead. This panda is dead. There seems to be no staff. No, level 5 panda dies. This is a big loss for Select and Ono. And this means level 5 Lich as well. We have level 3 Vampiric Aura now. We have level 1 Unholy Aura. Uses a sleep on a Sorc. Alright. Don't know if that is necessary. But the humans still have an expansion work for them. And this is a funny game, man. Goes back and forth and back and forth and back and forth. Good choice by the War 3 Arena replay section. So, opening a can here. Cheers to you guys. More shopping from the Lich. He has a Scroll of Healing, of course, to counter the Breath of Fire. But let's see the upgrades. 1-0 on the fiends. Ah, I can't see the skeletons right now. But the ghoul should have the same upgrades. But where are they? I think they're all dead. So this vampiric aura works great with the summons. Especially with the warriors, of course. And here we are. We see them again. 1-0 on the warriors. And oh, this blizzard, the Breath of Fire. Scroll of Healing had to be used. But there's so much more area of effect damage. All the summons are dead now. Level 4 on the DK. The army of gyrocopters is not enough. Now Web comes into play. So good kiting from the fiends here so far, but the blizzard, he's hitting them so hard, needs to reposition them, but the fiends, they all go down. The fiends have zero chances against the breakers. And the destroyers try to dispel more, but it looks like the human have this in their pockets. 50 and 58 versus 52 and 41. Oh yeah, the undead with the casters. He's losing so much, but what can he do? What can he do? There's another breath of fire. Is that cooldown or something? Yeah, 2-1. Not hitting it now, but a little too late. Double TP out. Oh, no. Oh, only one. One town portal. Ay-yay-yay-yay-yay. The caster undead is the weakness now for Team UD. Maybe transition into Banshees. Ooh, Holy Light. Thank God there's no Stormbolt for the DK right now. Ooh, Breath of Fire hits nothing. And the Gyrocopters, they all die. And there's no anti-air anymore. There's just Breakers and Knights. And, of course, the Archmages. One Gyro joins the fray now. Hey, this is getting close. Of course, the time works for the humans, thanks to the expansion. And the main gold mines are down. Main gold mines are down, so the only income is the expansion from... Oh no. Okay, they want to break the base of Tanyudi again. I would love to see an Infernal being dropped. This Abomination we will not see. And yeah, they have no Siege. The Spellbreakers do very little damage. Only two statues, but they will never attack them. Yeah, here we see the casters, the summons again. Nova immediately being thrown to the Pandem Brewmaster. Oh, he gets so many hits, man. Is the Paladin around? Yes, he is, but almost out of mana. He needs to be so careful. Here comes the Holy Light, saving it. But the Destroyers once again take good care, and with the Disease Cloud, look at the damage of the Catapults. Blizzard thrown once again. The Blizzard is really a game changer here. But the positioning of the casters is really good, so you can't really hit them. And ooh, Pen and Brewmaster in problems once again. Nova has been hit, Invo Potion being used. There is, no coil. DK has to be very, very careful. He's kind of trapped, and yeah, has to town portal out here. The panda is still alive, but here comes the town portal as well. This is two undead versus one human now. Level 2 Holy Light saves the panda for, I don't know, the fifth time or something. And now the numbers speak in favor of the undead, especially if you consider all the casters. Let's see how many he has here. Only 5 and 3. That's not too much, but of course the destroyers are really good. I think Griffins would be better than Gyros. Just because, I don't know, they do more damage. Of course they are more expansive. But there are not that many fiends, and he doesn't have the money. With the expansion, I think transitioning into Griffins now would be key. But yeah, here comes the second expansion of the human 2-on-2 team. Of course, we will never see an expansion from the undead. Most likely they'll sell their buildings and invest everything into one last push. This expansion pretty breakable now. And we see a level 6 Dreadlord. He has Infernal skilled here, everybody. He has Infernal skilled. And Death and Decay. Death and double ultimate for the undead. No ultimate for the human. But he's getting closer. He's getting closer and closer and closer. But I think the time where the summons grant you a lot of HP is over. So what does they really have? 5 priests, that's not too much. 5 priests is not too much. He can pick them off with Nova and stuff and the destroyers. 4 breakers. Oh, he is going for an expansion. It has been scouted, I guess. Yeah, thanks to this militia. 4 breakers, only one knight. This is a very, very tiny army the human has, but the heroes, they will deal with it. Here comes the Infernal, stunning everything! And now the area of effect, this is kind of like Immolation, but the Blizzard, he's kind of out of position, would be snipeable. I don't know where the Lich is right now, but the Catapults are in a beautiful situation, beautiful position. Now they're trying to chase the human heroes. Of course, the Archmage is very, very squishy. But the Pendulum Brewmaster is the first target, and he dies. Here's the Lich back in action, level 6 for him. The Breath of Fire on the Dispel, nice combination, but the Panda is kinda exposed. The Panda is kinda exposed. Is there a follow-up to that? Yes, it's a Staff, and the Staff heals him. The Infernal, of course, gets HP back from the Vamp Aura, so he kinda regenerates when he hits. And yeah, the Undead are already... sure that they won this, but there are 2 expansions running, but we have Death and Decay, but no mana on the Lich, but on the Destroyers, and they deal so much damage, man. He has to get rid of them, and thanks to Immolation, the workers take a lot of damage. Thanks to the catapults, the Town Hall is gone. And this is still 51 and 41 with a 36 and 33. But the Infernal is gone, as I see here. And the Paladin is back. Can they nuke something? Undead only attacking with the Destroyers at the moment. But here comes the rest of the army. Level 7 Dreadlord. He can sleep everything now. All the time when the Panda wants to hit the Breath of Fire. Oh, there's the ultimate! The Panda and ultimate! Storm, Earth, and Fire. He can use it now. There's level 6 on the Death Knight. Oh, Nova. Follow up. Nope. X Breath of Fire not hitting that much. And here's the ultimate! DK has to be so careful. Now we have Cyclone, we have everything. But Lightning is already down. New summons being spawned. And we see Carrion Swarm. Yeah, very nice. Hitting not that much, but maybe later. Maybe later. He's going for the hunt on the Archmage. He's sleepy forever now. Yeah, Priest goes down. He's not able to wake him up. Wake me up when September ends. And here we go. Carrion Swarm. Where's the coil? Oh, there's no mana again. Can he save himself? Invis Potion. But nope, not fast enough. Archmage dies as well. So, oh, he apparently got his Panda back. And he's fighting it. All the catapults, there's a lot of Breath of Fire coming in. Wow, 2 catapults gone, but the Panda as well. Level 6, can he split again? Can he split again? No, there's cooldown. But the potion saved him. And there's more Breath of Fire, but it's nothing. That was really sloppy. This expansion is still running, mind you. The humans can get new food. New supplies, whatever. Oh, the Panda. There's too much shield. Too much shield from the statue. He needs to pick up the statue. Staff saves the Panda. 1 expo down, 1 to go. This is fun. Seeing Necros in a game is always great. Bit sad that I didn't see a Frenzy. But of course he uses all the mana for the skeletons. It's a nice synergy, actually. The aura, the vamp aura, and the skeletons. Ooh, Archmage, go home! Yes, he does. But there's more harass, and he can send more and more and more and more skeletons in there. Double level 7. And the Undead has an expansion up again. This one got cancelled somewhere, somehow. But there is income. Let's see for how long. Wow, all the Acolytes will die to the next Breath of Fire. He's trying to save them, and he succeeds. But the next arrest will be crucial, and he's coming. Boom, Breath of Fire. But why is this Panda not attacking? Ah, okay, he's healing, I see. Healing from the Staff of Sanctuary. I think the Panda should just walk over here. Ah, nice heal. The statues. The undead statues. So good. Oh, DK. Needs to save the DK. He needs healing. But here comes the next breath of fire. Where's the second breath of fire? Didn't hit him yet. There is Holy Light and the DK dies. No healing anymore, but double stun with the Infernal. This could end horrible, but is there a follow-up? Is once again the question here. Where is the Lich? Where is my mind? Here's the Lich. Tries to escape. Dreadlord is super slow. He has no boots. There is more Holy Light. There is more Holy Light hitting him. Breath of fire combination. What item does he get? Invul potion. Alright. The Infernal is still on the battlefield, but he can't do much against heroes. Oh, he has to be so careful! He's not! The undeads are throwing this game away! He wasn't careful enough! He knew that there was Holy Light Breath of Fire coming, and he still didn't pop the Invul. Trying to get a revenge now with the Lich, but only the Lich is not enough, even if he's on level 8. All the human heroes are here. All the five heroes. And here comes the Lich, trying to get the Archmage. He can't escape. He still gets healed. But there is one more Holy Light. Yes, and that should be enough. Oh no, he's not. He's trapped. The Archmage is trapped so close to level 6. And down he goes. What a horrible, horrible death. Unable to move. This is like a lucid dream where you can't wake up from and you die. Imagine that. Horrible. Horrible, horrible, horrible. But it's undead, so you need to do such things. Slaughter, torture, stuff like that. And the second expansion is down. He mobilized his entire army once again, with the summons and all. Ooh, what a staff. And oh no, has already been has already left the game. Can Dirk do it on his own? There's only the Lich as a hero. Oh no, the DK is back. The DK is back. I think he sold some stuff or got the haunted gold mine running. But yeah, it is working now with the DK back. He has healing on the Lich. Dreadlord will most likely not return. What an interesting game, man. What an interesting game. No... Okay, there's just this income here. This one. But Tonyu D wants to end this game now. He wants to end this game now fast and a quick... Or, well, not fast, but with a hard push. The summons expire. He has 19 left. Well, the number reduces rapidly. He goes into the undead main base. There is death and decay, and there is no disable. There's no Stormbolt. There is nothing. He only needs to keep the Lich alive, and half of the base is gone. Of course, there's Cyclone with the Panda ultimate, but he does not pop it yet. He does not pop it. He gets rid of all the summons once again. What's going on here? Nothing important, I guess. Staff out. And that will be enough. Yeah, with 100 hit points, DK would be in range too. Or would have been in range. Lich needs healing. I think there's a statue. Yes, with full mana. So he gets healing. All he needs to do... Oh no. They don't have gold anymore. They don't have gold anymore. And the only item left that he can sell is the boots or one staff. Wow, Holy Light saves him in the last second. Can they nuke something now without the Dreadlord? There's no slow, there is no aura anymore. So the skeletons die much faster. Breath of Fire again. He needs to get rid of this position for the undead. It's just perfect with a blocking Tomb of Relics in front that gets healed. Well, down he goes, but this means, of course, more corpses, more summons, and here comes Earthstorm and Fire again. Will the human win this, or will the undead take this home? This is mass casters versus casters. This is so fun to see, but now the panda, Holy Light again. This paladin is so great, but now the Archmage is exposed. Is there another Nova? Can he follow that up? There is a coil, but he's not following him. But he's faster, I think. Now he has vision. I think he has vision with the statue. Will we see a long-range coil? Ah, this is so close. This is so close. Ring around the forest. He needs to save the Archmage. And he does. And he does. Crazy. Crazy. Oh, but now the Paladin. Ay. Can he block him until the Divine Shield expires? Can he block him? Yeah, he can. It is about to expire, and here we go. The Lich just waiting for the Nova. Come on, kill him in style. It's only... It's done now. Coil Nova! Bam! Down goes the Paladin. A little waste of mana, though, but safe. Better safe than sorry, right? Invis Potion on the Archmage again to at least keep him alive. With his 200 HP. He has to wait until the Pendant Ultimate is available again. And then maybe he can pick the Death Knight. No, here comes Nova. Where is the coil? Where is the coil? He was waiting for the coil for so long! And finally, he's able to hit it. First hero down for the human. No Archmages anymore. And finally, we see Cripple. Minus damage, minus movement speed. And now the Panda. It's time for him to go. And there is nothing the humans can do anymore. No! Okay, he can do that. He can split into three pandas. Earth, Storm, and Fire once again. Is there Cyclone? Will he use Cyclone to trap the Death Knight? Ah, doesn't look too good. He needs to use the Cyclone or the coil comes. But, ah, Frenzy. Look at the Frenzy. Got dispelled now by the Cyclone. But the movement speed and the attack speed was just so great. Nova now. Holy shit. This is so fun, the Lich in problems, but now the Lightning Panda is gone, and the Fire Panda is also gone. Only the Earth Panda survives. Can he save him? No, he can't! Panda and Brewmaster goes down, and the second one will not survive for a long time. Everybody calls GG, and indeed, this has been a great, great, great 2-on-2. Very cool to see the unit compositions, the diversity of the units. Because we haven't seen Necromancers in forever. So this is very, very cool. Thank you to all the four players. And thank you to the staff that provided us with this replay. So once again, this Friday is the WCA Open Qualifier. Please do me a favor and take part. Sign up, take part, play, have fun. Even if you don't have realistic chances to go to China and win this tournament. But still, do it for the lulz. And of course, yeah, what can I say? Buy our merch, donate via PayPal if you want to, or otherwise, leave us a comment. This is also super, super great to read your feedback throughout the past weeks. It's been a great ride so far through this autumn, and we will continue the Rocktober on Friday, at least. On Wednesday, I'm at the Back to the Future Marathon here, because it's, of course, Marty McFly Day, to watch all the three movies. I don't know what Remo is doing. I will ask him, so maybe there's iFan Cup tomorrow, but we will see about that. We'll keep you up to date on our Facebook and Twitter. Thanks for watching this. Neo out.